everyone, welcome back to another one of my videos. Today's video is a figure review on the episode 1, 1999 Battle Gown Queen Amidala. This is an updated review. I reviewed it once, and I did a comparison video with the other Battle Gown Queen Amidala figures, but I wanted to do a better review of her. So, yeah, and if you have any, of course, any requests for any figure review or reviews, countdown videos, or any videos at all, just let me know. Because I'm kind of running out of ideas, but I might do a couple videos today. So before anything, we are going to, of course, take a look at the packaging. She comes on the basic episode 1, card. This was the first release of the figure of Padme in her battle gown. We have the Darth Maul face in the corner, the Star Wars Episode 1 logo, a Padme Queen Amidala picture, profile picture, the contact chip, the figure in the bubble. On the back, it says, Queen Amidala, the young and newly elected ruler of Naboo. Queen Amidala desperately attempts to save her planet from the greedy Trade Federation with the help of Jedi Obi-Wan, Qui-Gon Jinn, and Obi-Wan Kenobi. Then, her lines, what she says on the concept chip. A bio about episode 1. Information about the concept chip. The other figures are, Battle Droid, Jedi Qui-Gon Jinn, Battle Dress Queen Amidala, of course, Darth Maul, Anakin Skywalker, Padme Nibiri, Jar Jar Binks, and Jedi Obi-Wan Kenobi. So this packaging, now her articulation is of course basic, as she was released in episode 1-9. She has a swivel in the head, swivel in the shoulders, swivel in the waist, and swivel in the hips. So for this being an episode 1 figure, I think it's one of the better ones. The detail on her is pretty nice. You know, the detail on her dress is pretty nice. It's a lot better on the movie Heroes Padme in her battle dress. But, you know, before those came out, this was the only battle dress Padme we had. So, but she has nice detailing on her sleeves and on her pants. This is just blue tack, what I use to stand my figures. It works really good. The hair has pretty nice detail on it too. The face sculpt, I think it is, in my opinion, one of the closest Natalie Portman face sculpts. It's one of the better ones. I think it resembles her really nicely. She looks young, and she looks like Padme did in the movie. Now her accessories, I don't have her accessories anymore, because originally I got this Padme at a swap meet for like 50 cents, 25 or 50 cents, and that was fine. I never went after one with her accessories until I wanted a carded one. So my carded Padme is my actually first one I got with all her accessories, but I'm not opening that one because that's part of my carded collection. But these fit nice in her hand. They are I gave her Cad Bane's blasters, and they fit nice in her hand. So yeah, they look nice in her hand too. I mean, honestly, if you're gonna get one Padme in her battle outfit from episode 1, the movie Heroes one is really nice. I do like that one. I'll just show a quick comparison to her. It's really nice. The face sculpt looks a little older than 14 years old, or 16, because Natalie was 16 when she did episode 1. I mean, the detail on her is obviously better, but if you're gonna if you want one that more looks like Natalie Portman, the character, I'd get the episode 1, 1999 one. But if you want one with obviously more articulation and a little bit more detail, get the Movie Heroes one. I mean, obviously, if you're a big Padme fan like me and want to get all of them, you're going to have to get both. So, anyway, this was a figure review on the episode 1, 1999, Queen Amidala in her battle gown. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to my channel, and as always, may the force be with you. Bye.